Well, the Iranian nuclear issue is something that's been at the top of the international agenda for over a decade now. So the new agreement will basically curb Iran's nuclear advancement and allay many of the concerns that Iran is intent on acquiring nuclear weapons. It will buy time for the diplomatic process to work and hopefully move the situation towards a more lasting diplomatic agreement.
What are the technical details that could still be a problem?
Well, what Iran have, the P5 plus one and Iran have negotiated a couple of things. Four key things on the Iranian side. Iran has agreed to cap enrichment at 5%. Now, why this is significant is because it takes a lot of effort to acquire the know-how and technology to enrich uranium to 5% and then up to 20%. But once you've reached that 20% mark, it's actually relatively easy to then continue enrichment up to the 90% required for a nuclear weapons program. So it's significant that Iran has agreed to cap enrichment at 5%. The other significant thing is that Iran has agreed to neutralize its existing stockpile of 20% enriched uranium. So what they'll do there is convert some of this stockpile to a form that isn't suitable for use in a nuclear weapons program. And then finally, in technical terms, another significant thing is that Iran has agreed to halt production on key aspects of the Arak heavy water reactor. Now, once operational, that reactor would provide a source of plutonium and potentially another route to the bomb for Iran. So these developments are crucial. And as I said, now it's important to bear in mind, they are reversible, but as I said, they have bought time for the diplomatic process to move on and to move towards a lasting agreement.
So how close is Iran to a nuclear weapon if they decide to break the agreement?
Well, that's almost impossible to say. I mean, there are a huge amount of estimates out there ranging from a couple of months to a couple of years. And it really depends on how they approach the problem. But it's important to bear in mind that there's no evidence that a political decision has been taken in Tehran to acquire nuclear weapons. So really, it's all speculation at the moment. However, we do have to say that Iran has gone beyond what's strictly necessary for a civil nuclear program, and this is, of course, why there are such concerns.